and girls, in the previous classes we learned budgetary procedure and also the federal finance and the principle of federal finance also we have seen all the 9 principles. Today we are going to learn the history of finance commission. I already told the finance commission is a separate body. It's a quasi judicial body. What do you mean by quasi judicial body? It acts as a government, but it is not a government. That is quasi. Quasi means we can say half or not real. That is quasi. That means it is a judicial body. It is comes under the control of the constitution, but it is not government. It was set up under the Article 280 in the year 1951. Why the Finance Commission was set up? What was its aim? It defined the finance fiscal relationship between the center and the state. So, the Finance Commission was set up on the basis of these aims. What are they? To reduce the imbalance between the allocation of resources center and the state. And also to allocate the funds or the imbalance between the center and the state in the vertical imbalance. What do you mean by vertical imbalance? What is the meaning for vertical? Vertical means it should be in a straight line from upwards to downwards. So vertical means from top to bottom. That means from center to state. And also the horizontal imbalance. Horizontal means it should be in a parallel between in the states, between the regions. The imbalance between the states, that is between their regions of their states, from the center to state and state to their region. So it reduces the imbalance, the fund financial imbalance between the center and the state, both in the vertical imbalance and also the horizontal imbalance. This is its first objective. What is its second? It was set up once in 5 years. The period of a finance commission is once in 5 years. But the third year itself, while the period is going on, for example, the first finance commission I told, it was set up in the year 1951. So it extended up to 1956, isn't it? So in the year 1954 itself, they started the next finance commission. There will be a temporary setup of a finance commission before the 2 years of the end of the period. So the period of finance commission is 5 years. And the 14th finance commission was set up in the year 2013. So what would be the time of the period? Sorry, the 14th Finance Commission is set up up to 2013. Its recommendations were valid. What is its recommendation? So 2015 it started, isn't it? As I said, 2 years before they set up the Finance Commission. But the function starts after the 2 years. So 2013 they set up the 14th Finance Commission. They executed their function 2015 onwards. 5 years means 2015 to 2020 is the 14th Finance Commission year. So the year start from, as I said, April to March. That is the period of Finance Commission. And the 15th Finance Commission is set up in 17th November 2017, as I said, because 20 is going to be over. So the 18, 19, they have to start planning for the next finance commission. So it was set up in the 2017. The work starts from 2020 March to 2025. That will be the period of 15th finance commission. Now we are going to see the local bodies, functions of the Finance Commission of India under local finance. What is the function of Finance Commission of India? What is its function? Why it was set up? What was its functions? Article 280 explain the functions of Finance Commission. It states that the duty of the commission to make the recommendations to the president. So the Finance Commission has the authority to convey the recommendations to president. Don't confuse the Planning Commission and the Finance Commission. Planning Commission report to Prime Minister. Finance Commission report to President. Mind it. And then, what would they decide? The distribution between the union and the state, the taxes and the allocation of funds and other things, the respective shares of the procedures, everything will be discussed in the Finance Commission and they will give report to the President. And Article 275 determine the principles governing the eligibility of the states for grant in aid, grants and other things, subsidies, grants and other things. Regarding that, they will, the Article 275 talks about that things. And then any other matter referred by the commission to the President of India is established or has come out in the fiscal economics or fiscal finance. Everything will be implemented or executed in the fiscal economics. So whatever it may be, the debt relief, financing, calamity relief, additional excise duty, whatever it may be, everything will be recommended by the Finance Commission to the President based on the public finance. And then we are going to see the local finance. What are all the local bodies? The local finance refers to the financial of local bodies, finance of local body. Because India is a large country, so there is a variety of local bodies in India. In India, we have four type of local bodies. The one is village panchayat. These you have studied in your previous classes in your lower sections. Panchayats, Zilla Parishad. Jilla Parishad and then municipalities, and the municipality corporations, municipal corporations. These are the four local bodies performing in India, and they are dividing how they are getting the revenue, what are all the expenditure they are meeting, how they are dividing their income, everything we are going to study. The first one is village panchayat. It is judicial of a panchayat, usually confined to one revenue village. Usually the village panchayat will be a revenue area of only one village. Sometimes if there are small villages, two or three villages will be joined together and they will have village panchayat. So based on the area, sometimes only one village is considered to be a revenue area. Some other time, if there is only less number of people are there, only the area of the village is very small, 2 to 3 number of villages were collected together and it will be considered as one revenue area, one village panchayat. And this panchayat is the largest odd policy of most state in India. Already there are self-explanatory policies are there. What do you mean by that? How they have to move, what they have to do, everything were given. Everything will be given to them. What are the things they have to do? For gramangalla, grama panchayatin solradala, they will have a head of the village. Thalayari, grama munsi kunjurvanga.
ஆனா கிராமத்துல தலையாரின்னு சொல்வாங்க ஹி இஸ் தி ஹெட் ஆஃப் தட் வில்லேஜ் ஹி இஸ் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிள் ஃபார் தி திங்ஸ் which are happening in the villages ஹி ஹஸ் டு கலெக்ட் தி ரெவென்யூ வில்லேஜஸ் ஏரியால என்னடா ரெவென்யூ வர போகுது அக்ரிகல்ச்சரல் லேண்ட் ரெவென்யூ ஃபார் ஆக்ட்ராய்ட் தட் மீன்ஸ் அவங்களுடைய விளை பொருட்களை வேற ஒரு இடத்துக்கு கொண்டு போகும்போது தே ஹவ் டு பே த டாக்ஸ் அந்த டாக்ஸ் water facilities whatever it may be they are providing they have to collect the tax from the villages that is village munsip appdi solvanga illana gram munsip solvanga illana ipo VAO nu solrom village administrative officer so he is responsible for that particular village he has to take care of everything in the village whatever it may be water facilities toilet facilities road facilities and in those areas they do not have school and other things they do not have a separate water system in the village areas we have a separate water tank for whole village they will kept a cement tank from that tank only they will provide water to all the villages people will come there and they will fetch water so all those things should be taken care by the village administrative officer the head of the village
And what was their function? They have to include that small disputes and other things they have to tackle. And the roads, primary schools, whatever we told that they have to take care of. And how they are getting the revenue? Property tax, tax on land, profession tax, and tax on animals and vehicles. So they will collect the tax on animals and vehicle also. They will during village side they will collect these tax. And other taxes like service tax, octroi.
The octroi only the tax which is collected by the by one village while we are transporting the goods from one village to another village. Transporting or exporting the goods from one village to another village, one area to another area, we have to pay the tax at the border of the village. That is octroi. The tax name is octroi. The production goods, if it is moving from one place to another, they have to pay the octroi. And taxes on birth and deaths and other things will be collected.
Second one is Jilla Parishad. Jilla Parishad also it will be a revenue level on the district level.
So village is on the village level. Jilla Parishad is a district level.
District level. So here in rural areas, district boards or Jilla Parishad are established at a district level. So here also jurisdiction of a district board is generally a revenue district. District. So Tamil Nadu, the Jilla Parishad coordinating body, supervise what they have to do. They have to supervise the working of panchayat samitis.
So these people will take care of the panchayats. Village panchayats. So the village panchayats comes under the control of Jilla Parishad
and advises them, and also they will implement the development schemes. So here also they will collect the tax, toll fees, grant in aid, income from the property tax, and the grants for generally sponsored schemes relating to the development work. And the third one is municipalities. The next one is municipalities. Municipalities also they are the bodies or institution which are established in the urban areas.
That means city sites, isn't it? Rural areas we have village panchayat and Jilla Parishad. In the urban areas, cities, we have municipalities and municipal corporations.
So what are their work, what they have to do? They have to take care of the local affairs, just as sanitation, parks, water facilities, gardens, hospitals, government dispensaries. So they have to take care of these things, primary education and other things. How they are getting their revenue?
What are the sources of revenue? As I said, in the village panchayat and Jilla Parishad, they too have collected the revenue on taxes. most of the revenue we collect only from the taxes, taxes on property, taxes on goods, particularly the octroi and the terminal tax. I already informed personal tax, tax on profession, trade and employment, theater and show tax, taxes on vehicles and other things. So these are the revenues of municipalities, municipal corporation. The next one is what we are living, isn't it? Our Madurai is corporation, so municipal corporation. What are the work the corporation is doing? They are providing the drinking water. Nowadays they are digging the road and they are laying, constructing new roads, isn't it? Well, sometimes they will construct the small bridges and they are repairing the road, reconstruction, everything they are doing. So it has a wide power and greater freedom as compared to municipalities. Compared with municipalities, corporations have more power and they are usually entrusted with the functions, water supply, drainage, lightning, slum clearance and other things. They too have collected the revenue from the property, tax on vehicle, trade, theatres and show tax, advertisement, octroi and terminal tax. So the corporation, they have a fair degree of freedom in respect of their choice and modification of their taxes to the maximum and the minimum rates laid down by the law. So they have the power to collect the taxes. Either they can increase somewhat based on their requirement, either they can increase their tax or they can decrease their tax based on their requirements only. So they have the power more than municipalities. So these are the local finance we have till now we studied. Then we are going to study the last subdivision, fiscal policy.